Metro Plague, Metro Plague. Oh my god, oh my god, what is...
So I'm just going to throw this out there, right? Leave no dwarf behind, none whatsoever, unless it's a friend who does something stupid like falling down a chasm just as you're about to extract, in which case then Billy, you're on your own. Space dwarfs, alien creatures, bloody mayhem, the most dangerous planet in the galaxy, combined with mining and beer. I guess beer is definitely what seals the deal. Now, as far as combinations go, that's not a bad one. You can forget your Ori and your Dory, your Gimli, your Thorin Oakenshield, forget your Grumpy, your Sleepy and your Doc. They wouldn't cut it down on Hoxus. Only the toughest or drunkest dwarves survive. So what's up, you beautiful feckers? How you all doing? Now, if you enjoy multiplayer squad-based shooters, then please do not ignore Deep Rock Galactic like I did for as long as I did, because it ticks so many of the boxes. So if you're looking for a game that has an incredible fun gameplay loop while also having, I guess, challenging content, and on top of that to have a helpful, meme-filled, enjoyable community that is very helpful, then you don't have to look too far, because Deep Rock Galactic has all of those and above ticked off. Starship Troopers meets Left 4 Dead with loads of sprinkles on top of it, I guess spider sprinkles in some sense. Ghost Ship Games have created an absolute gem of a game. A game that I played a little bit of in the past and kind of just goofed around in it. I didn't really dive deep into it, excuse the pun, until now. Fully destructible and procedurally generated maps for each mission. You can't find a path to your objective, then simply make your own. Alien bugs that bite, bugs that spit, bugs that tickle, bugs that pick you up and fly away with you, uber bugs, and big feckin' bugs that explode. The Crassus detonator is an absolute nightmare fuel when you see it coming towards you. Unless it's covered in gold, then all bets are off and its ass is grass. On top of that, now Deep Rock Galactic's soundtrack is absolutely amazing. Check it out on YouTube or on Spotify if you can find it. It is a really good game soundtrack. But when it comes to some of the exploding creatures, mining into a resource only to turn around and then there's a set of small exploding bugs blocking you from getting back out of, I guess, the crevice you just mined yourself into, does definitely create the manliest of screams, because you know that you're dead, or listening to a teammate as they get carried off by a bug and then you turn around only to see their red outline in the distance flying off screaming is some of the funniest shit you will have with friends. Now basically Deep Rock Galactic is a game about dwarfs mining in space for valuable resources while fighting off swarms of alien insects or creatures, resources that are then used to upgrade those dwarfs, from weapons and armor upgrades to armored beards. I mean, you can put armor on a beard, mustaches, sideburns, helmets, night vision goggles, so on. You can buy new types of beer to share at the mining rig bar. You can dance at a jukebox, you can kick barrels into a big fiery ring. Cosmetics are more or less all earned in game from credits that you get from running missions, or from assignments, or from chests that you can find in certain missions, or helmets that you have to scan. You're basically a squad of dwarfs working for a company and drinking beer in between missions. Beer that will buff you for your next mission to find more gold, increase the resource gain, allow you to hit harder with your pickaxe. Beers that then make you fart, beers that make you black out, beers that makes you shrink, dance, teleport out into the blackness of space and freeze you solid. You're basically a squad of heavily armed party space dwarfs with big guns, and you're foul-mouthed as well. I mean, if you shoot a teammate in a mission by accident, you will get a lot of abuse back off them. But for the good of the company, don't shoot your teammates. There is team damage in this game, and you will be the cause of, I guess, killing them sometimes. So I've spent over 70 incredible hours streaming this game over the last week and a bit, and I've honestly been blown away by, first of all, how much fun it is, right? That has to be the key factor, but how much there is to do in the game as well, how much there is to earn from player progression to character progression to upgrades, and of course all of those cosmetics. I've only just started to scratch the surface, and while streaming it, I have spoken to players who have hundreds and hundreds of hours in Deep Rock Galactic and still have a lot of things to earn and a lot of things to do, so they're not finished with it either. So there is definite value for money with this game. But I've also been blown away by how incredibly helpful and friendly the community is to, I guess, randoms jumping into squads with them. And I'm kind of annoyed, well, definitely annoyed at myself for how long it's taken me to properly jump into this game. It's been in early access for a little over 2 years, but it has now gone into full release, which is why I finally decided to jump into it and check it out, apart from the fact that I've constantly been told how good of a game it is. Now, if you prefer solo, because I know not everyone enjoys the multiplayer aspect of games, don't enjoy jumping into, I guess, public missions with randoms, or maybe your friends play on different consoles, then Deep Rock Galactic still has got you covered. There is a robot, a bot, that you can get as a companion. You start off with it, called Bosco. You can then fully upgrade it, and it can be an absolute machine. It will wreck swarms, it will help you mine everything that's further away that you can't reach, like gems up in high places, or resources on the roof or high up on walls that you can't get to. Not to mention, once it's fully upgraded, those rockets that can blitz the absolute crap out of the larger insects. So solo is definitely viable and a way for you to play the game if you want to go down that road. And since the enemies, and I guess the amount of enemies, kind of scale off of how many people are in your squad, then playing solo I think might be a little bit easier than playing in a squad if you're jumping into those deep dives, or if you're jumping into hazard level 4, 5 and onwards. Now, you can play Deep Rock Galactic on PC, Xbox, and it is soon to be released on PlayStation as well. And I will admit that originally I looked at Deep Rock Galactic as a mindless horde mode shooter that you could just jump in and out of when you wanted a little bit of quick fun, which you can do, but it has so much more going for it. Like account upgrades at certain milestones for completing assignments, like level 10, 20, 30 and so on your actual account. You get promoted within the company. Upgrades like new cosmetics, new armor cosmetics, new pickaxe skins, new weapons. There is character progression for each of the four playable classes, the driller, the gunner, the engineer and of course the scout as well, each with their own role to play in a squad. The driller of course drills, he also has a flamethrower or cryo cannon. The engineer has platforms to get to hard to reach places. The scout can grapple and kind of zipline itself or ripline itself up onto hard to reach resources. It's basically the engineer's best friend. The gunner has a zipline and a minigun. Each class has a different weapon set to unlock from the ones that you start out with. You can modify them and then fully upgrade them and eventually add overclocks to them, which are basically the end game items. Shotguns, submachine guns, miniguns, flak cannons, cryo cannons, dead space, like plasma cutter styled weapons. You get the idea, there is a lot to choose from, and some of these classes are also better at dealing with certain alien bug types. Flamethrower for the mini swarms that nibble at your feet, the breach cutter for shredding, I guess, anything that walks in its way, the sniper for shredding Praetorians by shooting them in the big green butt or big blue butt, the driller's throwable axes also hurt oppressors a lot. Weapon overclocks, like I said, are a way to modify your weapon's performance in a different way. Kind of think corrupted mods in Warframe. Overclocks that come with positives, or a balance of positive and negative, so maybe bonus damage but a smaller magazine, or a bigger magazine and a faster fire rate, and so on. But there is also unstable overclocks that can completely change how a weapon will react or will perform. Deep Rock Galactic has 5 different difficulties or hazard levels to choose from as well when you're selecting a mission, which the higher up ones you have to do assignments to eventually unlock. But these will range from the really mild kind of missions to the hardest one, which is basically, holy shit, is there no end to this swarm? I have no ammo. The insects keep coming. Can we call in an ammo resupply? No, we can't. What do you mean there's no nitro left? Shit, there's another swarm after spawning. Now there's a Crassus detonator. Time to run. You get the idea. It can get pretty damn hectic. Hazard levels also give different amounts of experience and resources, I believe, as well. So if you enjoy a challenge, then you can set it up however you want. And as I've already mentioned, the deep dives and elite deep dives are some of the hardest missions in the game to run. Now, I think, and I can be corrected in the comment section if I'm wrong, that the 3 elite deep dive missions range from hazard 4.5 to 5, and then the final mission in that set is hazard 5.5, so basically the hardest mission type in the game. And these are the missions, like I said, that you will have to run to eventually get your hands on some of these overclocks. And I believe there is a lot of overclocks to get, so it will take you several weeks to do them, because you can only do one deep dive a week. It's kind of like a raid. It will reset every, I think, Thursday, so today. And then you can do the elite deep dive after, and it's got a weekly reset as well. So you can only get your hands on a certain amount of overclocks per week, and then you have to wait for the following week for them to unlock and refresh and do again. Now, on top of all of the positives, which there is a lot, there is also the thing of, I guess, motion sickness that some players who have jumped into Deep Rock Galactic will suffer from, because there is very narrow tunnels that kind of range from being really bright to really dark. If you've kind of ran out of flares, that can bring it on. There is also a lot of head bob from the dwarfs as they're walking, and that can cause an issue for some players. I can't remember if you can turn the head bob off or not. I don't think I turned it off, so you're probably noticing it in the footage as well. Some people don't like the art style of the game, which I fully understand, but for me, it's more about fun. Graphics shouldn't really be an issue, and right now this game is an incredible amount of fun. And in terms of future content, they have got a roadmap active right now showing that there is new maps, new weapons, new enemy types, new planet biomes, new missions, new cosmetics, new beer types, and a lot more currently being worked on and set to roll out before the end of the year. So this game will expand even more than it is right now, and even more than it already has. So I'm going to be playing a hell of a lot more of Deep Rock Galactic, both on stream and of course both off stream with some of the people on my Discord. So it is worth checking out. But look, like I said, this game is one that I have completely slept on for the last 2.5 years while it was in early access, and I passed it off as just another hard mode game that was kind of mindless, jump in, jump out, forget about everything else. I didn't realize it had the progression system and it had different weapon unlocks and all of that going for it. So do yourself a favor, don't ignore it like I did. When it drops on PlayStation as well, it might be your style of game, so it's worth checking out. This video isn't sponsored, just in case someone thinks it is, and I can't believe I have to say that. It's just a game that I've been really, really, really enjoying over the last week and a half, and I'm going to continue enjoying for as long as I can. Check it out, like the video or don't, subscribe or don't, and as always, thanks very much for watching.
You've got a parade coming after you.
Yep, I fucking know.
No, he's fucking Molotov. Dude! Fuck
I stopped.
Me. You put me down. You put me down, you shot me.
I'm probably gonna go down after I finish you. Fuck it. Right, I'm down.
Do you know what's...
Oh, so we've played hopscotch here.
Dude, please say you're near us.
I'm on it.
For fuck's sake.
Well, I went down too.
You're gonna have going. You've got a long time to wait, do you? You need to try and stay alive while you're at that.
Oh my sweet fuck.
Because there is
why now?
Well,
why now?
As soon as the mule gets there, it'll open it up, and if he gets in,
but
dude,
he's ahead of the mule.
About it. It'll,
I'm
it'll
about to die.
Down. Dude, he's ahead of the mule. And he's about to die. Yep, there we go.
No.
You've no way of getting energy, though. You've no way of getting health.
We got so far.
We're at the end.
Do we have to do all three missions again, or just that one?
No, it's the full thing.
The whole thing? Oh, I don't know if I can be arsed, to be honest with you.
But screw you, chat! We got damn near to the entire end!
I was doing so well until Badger shot me and killed me.